football fans that are out there. You'll see him on Saturdays on the CBS network with the SEC network. He's a good friend of mine. You guys are going to love this guy. He's the Monday morning linebacker. You know, it's called the Monday morning quarterback. We call it the Monday morning linebacker. He's going to be bringing a lot of energy and juice to you guys as we move forward in this company. He's from New York City. Y'all give it up for my good friend, Mr. Brian Jones!
I know who he is. All the good stuff and all the bad stuff, just a little bit of bad stuff. He's always getting me in trouble. And Paul as well, I've known him for a few decades now. Austin types, been in business with all these guys, so I know what they're about. I know about their passion, I know about their work ethic. And a lot of you are sitting out there thinking, man, I gotta get where they got. I've got to get to that level. I've got to be able to grab those certificates and being a double diamond or a diamond and all that. Well, how do you get there? You know, they talk about me and what I do now, working for CBS, but I didn't start at the top. I had to work to get there to the top. I didn't start at the top when it came to playing in the NFL like Jonas, who did a phenomenal job up here comparing traditional business to this business model. It doesn't start there. A lot of you know that it doesn't start there. As far as the broadcasting, when I was done playing NFL, leagues spit me out. I was sitting there wondering, what the hell am I going to do with the rest of my life? I paid lip service to Plan B, but I really hadn't figured out what was next as far as my path. So I go back to Austin, University of Texas, decide I'm going to finish my degree work. And while I'm there, I get offered the sideline reporting job. But it had a caveat. They had already assigned a sideline reporter for the upcoming season, so I was asked if I would humble myself and carry the parabolic mic. Bless you. Are you familiar? That's what I did too. I carry the mic. I started sneezing. And I didn't know what the hell are you talking about. What's a parabolic mic? I said, sure, not knowing what it was. Okay, now tell me what it is. So when you sit there and you're listening to a game, whether it's over the radio or you're watching a game on television, there's someone on the sideline or on the court or on the baseball diamond, they have this little satellite dish. You familiar with that? You see the person holding that little dish? Well, here I am, fresh out of the NFL, thinking I'm Mr. Big Stuff, even though I didn't have a Hall of Fame career or anything, but yet, I felt like I was worthy of a better job than that, but I'm carrying this parabolic mic. Like, wow, you're talking about putting your pride in your pocket. So that's where all this started. That's where this broadcasting career began, from that humble, or those humble beginnings. And the funny thing about that is, I'm on the sideline carrying this mic in every game. The producer's in my ear, you need to shut up. You need to shut up, because I'm yelling at the players, and I'm cussing, and unbeknownst to me, it's all coming through this mic. They hear me more than they hear the actual broadcasters. But we laugh about it now, but I'll tell you, week in, I was in monastery. Okay, I'm trying to But see, you're passionate about the game, you're fresh out of the game, you're seeing things that these young players and things that you didn't see when you were actually their age. You're seeing all this stuff evolve, and you're yelling it out to them, and of course, only people are hearing it are my producer and the people at home. And can't help them, right? So I say all that to say this, that those humble beginnings have helped me grow, and while at the time I'm traveling around with this parabolic mic, and I had to travel with this thing. I had to check that with my luggage whenever we had broken. Yeah. So I'm traveling around with this contraption, and it humbled me. I'm glad I did it, because it makes me appreciate everything I've accomplished since then. And I'll give you another quick anecdote about the career. So I've done this for a few years. Now I want to transition, do bigger and better things. My agent and I would send our tapes to Fox Sports, Southwest. No reaction, nothing. If you've ever been in entertainment business, you ship these tapes off to networks and executives, and more times than not, they just end up on that network or executive floor. So we knew that was probably occurring. Chance meeting, I'm playing a golf tournament in Austin, Texas, with a charity deal. I'm in the line after the round of golf to get some food, some fajitas, barbecue, because that's what they serve at golf tournaments in Texas. All the time. You want fajitas, you want some barbecue. Now, when I host my golf tournament, just a little side note here, we always had steaks. Jimmy, he can attest to this. Steaks, salmon. I'm going to change it up a little bit. But anyway, so I happen to meet the GM at Fox Sports Southwest, John Hyde. Only bad thing about him is he's a Texas A&M man. I don't know. We have Aggies in here, security. Okay, we're going to let you stay for a second. You're for good cause. We Longhorns and Aggies, we don't need to get. Anyway, John Hyde, I happened to run into him in the buffet line, and I was introduced to him. Hey, man, we've been sending you tapes of my work for months now. When are you going to take a look at it? And he promised me right then, hey, as soon as I get back up to Dallas, I'm going to take a look at your tape, and it will fly in for an audition. True to his word, goes back, he watches the tape, picks it up out of all the other tapes on his floor, and he pops it in. Tape, I can't tape, that just shows my age, right? Tapes. I didn't even say CDs or DVDs. I said tapes. It just dawned on me. Wow. So he watches it, flies me in. Knock out the audition. I knew everything about every player, their mama, their daddy, their play cousins, and everything. And I wouldn't shut up. The other guys were auditioning with them. They just won't let us go. No. I got the gig, and the rest is history. It's been a great journey. But once again, I say all that to say this. Sometimes we have to humble ourselves. My good friend Kenneth Sims, All-American, University of Texas, number one overall pick back when he was being drafted to the NFL. He was the number one pick. And he always said, when you have nothing in your pocket, put your pride in your pocket. And everything you've been hearing today is about that why. Why am I doing this? Is it to help someone else? Is it to help me? Is it to subsidize my economical situation? What's your why? My why on this broadcasting journey was something I had a passion for. I think you can tell that I can talk just a little bit. As a guy told me, the kids in here, the guy told me one thing that you got good voice. So, I played to my strengths. But what's your why? What is your why? My why was to keep plugging away, even though I wasn't where I wanted to be ultimately. I wasn't going to give up. What's your why in this business? Why are you doing it? I know why I'm doing it. I know why I'm a part of this company, because I believe in John Taylor. I have for 30 years. I believe in Paul Rogers. I mean, they're going to tell you the truth. I know who they are outside of this room. I spent that quality time with them, and hopefully you will as well. I know they're going to work like crazy to make sure you're successful. Buddy's going to do the same. Brian, co-founder, Austin Tice, other co-founder, they're going to do the same. So you've got all the help. I've heard all the speakers up here today, people who have brought you into this business or people who were brought into this business by others, and they said the same thing. It's about the team. It's about the teamwork. You know, when we do a show on a Saturday inside the SEC on CBS or inside college football on Tuesdays on our cable network, CBS Sports Network, you don't get to see everyone that's involved. There's a whole team. You didn't get to see the people that put these mics on us here today. You don't get to see the people that do that when I'm on television, the people that put the makeup on, the people that turn those cameras on. You don't get to see those behind the scenes folks. But without them, there is no us. Without them, I can't go out there and perform my job and not have to worry about whether or not I'm gonna be on air, whether or not I sound right, or whether or not my makeup is correct. Sometimes I have to pack it on a little bit, you know. Got a face made for radio. But the key is, man, that's not funny, man. Y'all just think, oh, man, you're good. Guys, bring me, can you laugh at that, man? No, dog, you all right. Yeah. Tough crowd. But those folks make this work. The folks that have brought you here today. And the folks that you're going to leave here and go help down the line. It's about that teamwork. Those are the people you lean on. We lean on each other. I lean on those camera folks, even though they're faceless. They're not nameless. I lean on producers. I lean on the makeup artists. I will move forward now because all of us collectively make CBS work, make those broadcasts on Saturdays or on Tuesdays or on Thursdays, what have you. Make them work. Make that production work. Same here in this industry. That's what works, that teamwork. You gotta lean on it. You gotta wear them out. I blew JT phone up. Once they introduced this hemp oil. As you know, the NFL over the last few years taking a lot of heat about concussions and whether or not they knew what was going on in that area and didn't disclose their research. Well, a lot of us, myself included, have been out there looking for something that could help us. Because I've had some moments. I shared one with Jonas behind the stage here where it's serious. But geez, out of me, man. I mean, I had one, I was about to go on camera and I couldn't remember what the hell it was. I had just looked at and researched and I was gonna walk from here to about that plant right there and I forgot everything. And I was like, what is going on? Found a couple of different supplements out there that worked, but nothing has worked like this hemp. Nothing. And I had I don't strain to recall things anymore. I don't walk in the room and say, what? You're not coming in. I told Paul last week, I was like, Paul, this stuff is too good. I'm remembering stuff I don't even want to remember. This is working too damn good, man. So we like reverse this or say there's a moratorium on remembering such stuff, circa, you know. But it's been amazing. I'm just blown away with the effects of it, and I get my four pumps up. I get up at 4:30 by 4 in the morning every Monday through Friday for my radio show. We're on from 6 to 9, nationally, Gio and Jones, CBS Sports Radio. Shameless plug. And I have my four pumps of my hemp oil every morning. I'm telling you, I go in the studio and I feel alive. And once again, not straining to recall information. I can look at stuff and I'll remember it. I don't have to write things down as much as I used to. I would sit there and my co-host would make a point on a particular subject and I'm waiting for him to conclude whatever it is he's saying. And I don't have to write notes. And I'm talking, you know, maybe 20, 25, 30 seconds while he's talking. I would not remember what it was I was going to say once he was done. So I got these copious notes I'm taking over here and waiting for him to finish. I'm not doing that as much anymore. I am not doing it. Yeah, thank you. That's what I'm saying. Woo! That's why I've been blowing up Paul's gonna take some money in my hemp while I'm gonna get here. I got a little stash, I'm taking back. Dr. Chris back there, I'm gonna jack him for that backpack. He's hiding something. Some of y'all gonna be a little shirt change on your hemp while I'm going back home, okay? Don't let it be. It's not on me. Now, I probably talked way too long, but I love these guys. They're more than just business partners. They're friends, and they're people I believe in, and I know they believe in you, and I know they believe in Prime My Body, and I know this business is going to soar. The products are phenomenal. One last mention of the product. The protein powder, I've been using that, but
thank you.
First product that Paul and JD sent to me was about a year and a half, 2 years ago, and I was out at San Francisco at the Super Bowl, and as you might imagine, there are a few parties going on around the Super Bowl. They just had one Super Bowl here, of course. And so I'm out there, I said, yes, send it to me, I'll try it. I said, yeah, you know, a few parties, and for some reason when I get dehydrated from a few libations, my skin gets really dry, and I got lotion on the next day. So, of course, that happened. One or two shots of tequila. And, okay, maybe more. Next morning, I throw that hydrate on. No lie. Immediately, text Paul, and man, this stuff is phenomenal. I didn't have to use the whole damn bottle or two.